thoracic imaging. We'll be talking about the basic knowledge about the thoracic imaging. We'll only be focusing on the chest X-ray. We'll not be talking about CT scan in this lecture. And at the end of the lecture, we'll be adding or we will be applying our knowledge to basically starting with the neonatal chest imaging, since they are mostly X-rays. So let's start by talking about some technical remarks here. When we talk about the X-rays, the term BA means the direction of the beam that is coming from the X-ray machine, as you can see. And the X-ray beam, usually exactly as the light source, it usually angles out as it goes further away. So and then it will hit the object or a part of the body that will be X-rayed, and that will be reflected as a shadow on the cassette that receives the beam. So this is how it will be recorded. The beam or the source needs to be 2 meters or 6 feet away from that body part that would be X-rayed, and this is to decrease the magnification, because as you move closer to the body, as the angle of the beam will be going more laterally, and then the image will be magnified more on the cassette that is recording the image. This is especially important also when we talk about PA or AP view, as we will talk. One other point is that body that is X-rayed needs to be as much as close to the cassette that is also recorded. So you need to have the cassette close or almost touching the body that's being to decrease this angle or the magnification of that body part and to make the image more sharper. This is why in the left side we can see here the PA, where the chest is the beam is coming from the back of the chest toward the back, and then from toward the anterior part, and then toward the cassette. However, on the right side, we see here the AP view. We can see the difference between them, that the heart here is much smaller, or at least normal size, compared to the large heart seen on the right side image, which is might be confusing for cardiomegaly. However, because this is an AP view, two reasons here. The heart is an anterior structure, so it will hit the beam initially, and then the angle will be wider, and then it will be reflected as a larger. So it will be obscuring more of the lung, and it will give you the false impression of a cardiomegaly. In addition, other thing is that this is most of the AP views are done in the supine position. So this will even make it worse and obscuring more areas of the lung, since the diaphragm will be elevated because the abdominal content will be pushing also the diaphragm upward. Moving forward, let's talk about other views of the lungs. If we have in the AP view an area of interest, or there is a lesion that you want to see that is behind the heart or the mediastinum or near the diaphragm, what is the view that we are going to order? It is the lateral view. You can see here on the lateral, any areas that are behind the heart, you want to see it from the lateral side. However, on this side, you will not be able to appreciate it. So lateral is in order to some areas that we want to delineate more. And then we will talk later about more. Lateral view is also and the left side touching the cassette. Why is that? We said because also, as the heart is an anterior structure, it's also more toward the left side. So you want to have any structure inside the thorax that might obscure more area of the lung you are interested to see toward the cassette to make it less magnified as much as you can. So you put always put the left side near the cassette unless you order it otherwise. So let's say we have two nodules on the right and the left. Both are similar in size, but if you take it from the right side, you beam the X-ray, this right-sided nodule will appear larger because it will hit the beam first. I just want you to grasp the idea of that any area that the piece will be bigger and then the other that is inside will be smaller. Now, let's move on and talk about this. You can appreciate any abnormality in this X-ray. You can see, look at the diaphragm. We can see on the left side of the diaphragm appear higher, which is not the normal. We usually have the right dome of diaphragm higher because we have the liver beneath it. So what is the next, let's say, view that we want to order now in this case when you see this? It will be the left decubitus. What is the decubitus? Now, when we have the beam of the X-ray that is going parallel to the bed or the parallel to the fluid, if there is a fluid moving into the pleural space, that's why this line came down. You can see the diaphragm level now appear to be normal because this was pleural effusion. So we ordered the lateral decubitus. We know that any intrapleural fluid will fall down with the gravity. However, if there are air, it will rise up. Knowing that, let's say we have a left pneumothorax in a patient like, let's say he's in ICU and he cannot sit or stand. We will order a left or a right decubitus view. Since we are interested in air, we most likely will order right lateral decubitus because the air is on the left side. If we order the left decubitus, then the left side will be down and then you will not be able to appreciate the level of the pneum of the air at the end of the at the periphery of the X-ray. Another view is inspiratory versus expiratory. Which one of them we prefer to have it routinely done? It's obvious that we would like to order the inspiratory because as you inspire, the diaphragm will be pulled down and you will have more area exposed of the lungs. And at the same time, you will have the also the heart pulled down and will have less magnification of the heart. And there will be more lucens in the inspiratory film versus the expiratory film. So does that mean we do not order expiratory film? No, we do order them. Sometimes when we have, especially in pediatric, when we have a unilateral wheeze and we want to rule out any focal air trapping. What does focal air trapping mean? When there is like a partial obstruction that allows the air in, but does not allow it out. So this will cause the air to be trapped in only small area of the lungs. And when we do the expiratory film, we will find that area to be more radiolucent. So this is what we do usually in case of foreign bodies. We allow the kid to, if he is cooperative, then we do expiratory film. If he is not cooperative, we put that suspicious area downward. يعني نعمله decubitus at the site of the area that we are expecting to have the foreign body. So usually, this will allow the air to escape because of the weight of the child. However, if there is a partial obstruction, that area will continue to be radiolucent. And this will be suggestive of the foreign body in there. And that's the difference between the more radiolucent inspiratory versus the expiratory. Okay, let's move on and towards some anatomy that we usually see even on everyday X-ray. Starting by A. What is that? This is the gastric bubble. B here is the costophrenic angle. C is the heart. E is the trachea. F is the carina. What is H? It's the aortic knob or the arch of the aorta. And then D is the descending aorta. And you can appreciate the descending aorta going down from here. G, it's the hilum, okay? And also the same anatomy on the lateral view. We have the B, costophrenic angle from here, and then on the lateral view. And then we have the C is the heart. And then we have E is the trachea. J is the ascending aorta, H is the aortic arch or the knob that we see it usually on the left side when we are looking at the AP view or PA view, and then descending aorta as it goes down. And usually it goes down and in the left side. Why we are looking at the side? Because we want to know what is anterior and what is posterior structure. It makes difference, and we'll talk about that later. So when we read the X-ray, we have to be systematic and make sure that you are starting with the areas of least interest, because we mostly miss them, especially when there is something serious. Then this is a one suggested reading, but you can use any other system, but at least you have to be systematic each time and not to miss the areas. So one area is to go with the least interest, which is usually the upper abdomen, which is outside actually the thorax. And then make sure that there is no abnormality in there, looking into the thoracic cage, mean not the lungs, the soft tissue around the lung and the bones, and then moving into the mediastinum, making the mediastinal, just comment on the mediastinal structure, and then finally going into the lung. When you go to the lung now, you don't start look at the lung bilaterally immediately. You take one lung individually and then start to compare. When we compare, we'll talk about that, what we do. If you want a mnemonic, then this is a mnemonic, not to forget it. Are there many lung regions, which is abdomen, thorax, mediastinum, lung that is unilateral, and then lungs bilateral when we compare the two sides each other. Okay, now let's go to the abdomen. When we scan the abdomen, we go below the diaphragm bilaterally. So we start by scanning the right side. And what is this area and below the diaphragm? This area should be smooth, and it should not have any heterogeneity in there until we reach the other side of the, over the left side. We usually see the first bubble, that is the gastric bubble, and then beneath it, we usually the splenic flexure or the splenic flexure of the colon is there, and then C definitely is the liver. Moving forward, we go and look into the thorax, but we are trying to ignore all the areas that has the air in it or the parenchyma. We are looking only into the bone and soft tissue. For soft tissues here, like the breast tissue here, it might confuse you with the densities. So this is not densities related to the lung. That's why it's important to look in there. Bones, and then scapula here, see, and then clavicles. Any area that are white in the lung fields, you have to appreciate it during the thorax view. And then moving forward to the mediastinum, it has two steps. The first step is looking at the airway. You look for the airway, and the second one is the other vascular structure. So in the airway, you look for the trachea and carina and major airways, and then you look into the vascular structure, which is the aortic knob, descending aorta, ascending aorta, hilum, heart. Make sure that everything is fine here and the mediastinum is not widened. And then you move forward to the lung finally. Okay, when we scan the lungs, as we mentioned, we go by moving each lung separately. So while you scan the lung, you always think that the air is radiolucent, yani black. So you go there until you find something white. And then when you find something white, you say, is this in the lung or the outside? Starting here, we say, these are posterior ribs, anterior ribs. And not only the ribs, you can see some here, some branching structures. These are vessels, so that is okay. Any branching structure is okay. So white branching structure, that's fine. As long as it doesn't go to the end of the thorax, it doesn't reach to the outer third of the thorax, then that's a vasculature, that's fine, because it has fluid inside it, then you will see it, that's normally. Keep scanning here, let's say that's vessels, it's branching, it's bone, it's branching, bone, bone, branching, until we reach area that is not bone, not branching, and like a nodule in here. So if you went and you might miss this one, but if you and also it's not compare bilaterally and make sure that the densities, let's say that this area is radio lucent and the other one is dense, then you would appreciate. If you're not comparing the two sides, you might pass it as normal because the density differs with inspiratory phase versus expiratory phase. So you have to have the both lungs compared to each other. Okay, let's move on. Moving on now to hyperinflation. How do we appreciate or how do we define hyperinflation in the lung? We usually have a hyperlucent lung bilaterally because, you know, the X-ray beam will be beaming a tissue that is spread over a larger volume, so it will be more radiolucent. So it will not absorb the beam. The diaphragm usually or normally is at the level of the 9th or the 10th rib. So let's start counting here. So anything that we below the 10th diaphragm will be hyperinflated. That's the first rib. Did anyone not appreciate the first rib? I see lots of people missing the first rib. Always, always look when you are counting the first rib at this rounded area that some people are misdiagnosing as a cyst or a pneumatocele or something area. This is the first rib and going from the posterior to the anterior. So you have always to consider this is as a first rib. Keep counting the second rib, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. And now we said that the diaphragm should be at the level of the 9th or 10th. Here we are still going, and this is the hyperinflation. We are still going, we have the 11th rib, and we can see the shadow also of the 12th rib below the diaphragm. But this is a definite hyperinflation of the lung. Lateral view, do we have signs of hyperinflation on the lateral view? And if there is yes, what do you think they are will be? Hyperinflation means that the air are trapped. So on the clinical examination, do any one of you knows what's the signs of hyperinflation or air trapping on the clinical examination of a child with obstructive disease?
Shallow breathing is one of them.
Shallow breathing?
Yes.
Could be since the child is have his breathing from the higher, like the residual volume is really higher, so we'll be have a shallower breathing. That's true. But there will be more diaphragm signs.
We would have a limited expansion of the chest during an inspiration, and also hyper resonance on auscultation.
Hello. Okay. During percussion, you mean?
During percussion. Sorry.
Yeah. So percussion widened because AB. Now. Sorry. Yeah. AB diameter will be widened because when there is hyperinflation, most likely it's related to an intrathoracic obstruction. That means that the air will go in, but it doesn't go out. So since the air goes in and doesn't go out, or at least it takes long time to be going out, then the second breath will start before he in. So we will have air that was not in there, and air that is trapped, and finally reaching to the point where he will have a shallow breath, and then will no more expansion of the lung because he already maximally expanded. And on the lateral view, you see the barrel shaped chest. Okay, so we have the barrel side, barrel shaped chest, pectus. Carinatum or excavatum? Carinatum, because the sternum will be pushed outward. And then prolonged expiratory phase. Here on the lateral X-ray, we have the sternum. That is pod. Pod means carinatum. You see the line? It's going outward. Then retrosternal clear space had increased. Usually this space is smaller. But here, it's this, the retrosternal is from the ascending to the descending aorta. This space is increased. You can see it on the lateral view. So when you order a lateral view on a child who's coming to you as asthmatic and you're not sure clearly about the diagnosis, at least you can categorize that as an obstructive disease. Okay. What will happen to the diaphragm with air trap? Definitely it will be depressed. You will lose the dome of the diaphragm that's usually there. So he does not have لما نقول shallow breathing because خلاص الديافرام ما عاد في مكان له يروح ينزل تحت في زيادة in addition to إنه the ribs that became really horizontal. Let's move on. Okay, so anatomy again. Now we are talking about all the anatomy inside the lung. We have, what do we have inside? We have the airways, and it's different from airspace. Airways, and then hilum, mediastinum, and then lung parenchyma. In addition, we have lung interstitium. Lung interstitium, you cannot point to a specific place in the lung. It's available in everywhere, in the airway, in the hilum, in the mediastinum compartment, on the lung parenchyma. It's everywhere. And it's usually, this is why it's important, because we see the bronchovascular interstitium can be thickened, the parenchymal interstitium, the intralobular septal parenchymal interstitial thickening. In the airway starts, I'm talking about airway, okay? Airway starts from nasopharynx down to the terminal bronchioles. Terminal bronchioles, what is all this area? It's conductive airway. It does not participate in respiration. It's a dead space. This airway does not participate in the space. So we have some specific diseases that are related to the airway. Let's say airway diseases, and it includes the congenital anomalies also. Next is the hilum. With the hilum, usually the site usually where we have on the medial aspect of the lung, where we have the large vessels and the bronchi enters the lung. Okay, and also the pulmonary veins coming from the lung to the back to the left side of the heart. Also, there is a lymph nodes that really get when we have a hilar enlargement. Sometimes the lymph nodes are really inflamed in this area. Now let's go to the mediastinum. We know that the different classification of the mediastinum, we usually classify it into posterior, middle, and anterior. Sometimes they include the heart, sometimes not. But we have to know what structures usually involved in each of the mediastinal structures, so we can, when we see on the lateral view, we can at least have a differential in our mind. Okay. The most important or the most part that we are interested in is the lung parenchyma. When we talk about lung parenchyma, we are talking as a general term. It's like a term that includes both airspace, you can see in this orange box, that included the alveoli and the alveolar duct. Airspace is different from the airway, is that this contributes to the gas exchange. And then when we have, then we will have the change in the gas exchange, CO2 and there will be also some interstitial structures also involved in the parenchyma. So when we are not sure that is this an interstitial versus airspace or alveolar disease, we can say it's a parenchymal lung disease. However, we are excluding airway disease. Okay. Moving forward now, the parenchyma also is subdivided into, it starts anything, you know, like is the lung parenchyma is lots of lobule, pulmonary lobule or secondary pulmonary lobule. All these lobules usually start distal to the terminal bronchiole, which is the last division of the airway, the conductive airway. These airways comes along with the accompanying pulmonary artery, and then they subdivide into acini. Acini means a group of alveoli coming together, and then the interface between the capillaries and the air will be there. And then the veins does not go back to the same space that the artery came from. They go into the interlobular space. This is especially important when we are looking at the findings on the CT scan, and then we see the shape. We're not going too deep into the CT scan, but this is just an image just to get the idea. These are the air space when we have alveoli filled with secretions or mucus plugging. But when the veins are engorged or the lymphatics are engorged, we have a different view. We have these interlobular spaces are becoming thickened because there will be there might be an engorged vessels, or let's say there is a be obstruction at the site of the left heart, then these backflow will appear on the lung, and you can see the appreciate the, that this is veins or lymphatic, it's not an artery. Okay, this is just to understand the idea. We're not going into more details in that. Parenchyma, as we mentioned, it's the alveoli and the supporting structure, and then guys will be, and usually it will be reducent. What do we have there in the parenchyma? We have vessels, we have lymphatic, we have connective tissue, and it's this all called the interstitium is any space that is in the parenchyma but does not involve the airway airspace. Sorry. So what will happen when there is interstitium? There will be still the lung will be aerated since the most of the spaces still have air in it. So we will still see aeration in the lung. When we look at a normal X-ray, we usually looking at the branching pulmonary arteries and veins. This is in the normal scenario. We do not have interstitial thickening because there will be veins, but we are not supposed to see them at the end, as we mentioned. Now, when we have an alveolar filling disease, what does it mean when we say alveolar filling? Alveolar means that there is a fluid inside the alveoli. It will automatically fill also the interstitial space. These fluids will leak there. So it will be white over white, and then you will not be appreciating the even the interstitium because the fluid will be leaking there. Alveolar diseases means like pneumonias, like pulmonary edemas, anything that will make the fill the alveolar space. So here we can appreciate the difference between an interstitial versus the alveolar marking. Here is the interstitium is white. However, that because the alveolar space is lung, we are still saying that this is an aerated lung. However, when it is white over white, you can see the homogeneous density in the lung because the alveolar. So this is an alveolar infiltrate. This is an interstitial infiltrate. Again, we can see here the disappearing pattern of the pulmonary vessels. We don't appreciate them at the end. However, when we see these reaching to the end of the lung, then we are sure that these are interstitial marking instead of an alveolar marking. Even though sometimes it have a background of whitish changes, then we might call them something else like grand glass opacities. But we know that there are some white stuff branching and reaching to the end means that this is an interstitial pattern and the interstitium being involved. Can we have another interstitial pattern other than reticular? Yes. The interstitium might not be totally filled, but might have some nodular changes. This nodularity, you can appreciate it like, let's say, miliary TB or any other disease that have a nodular species characteristics in the interstitium. And then this is in the CT, we'll talk more about that. This is the alveolar filling disease where you can see it's you cannot see the interstitium. As we mentioned, most of the interstitial changes when it comes without alveolar filling, this means that this is a chronic thing, and mostly it's due to fibrosis. However, it can be acute sometimes with the mycoplasma infection, and that sometimes the edema also can give you some of the interstitial acute changes. How do we know if the interstitial marking, like in this chest X-ray, is new or old? Give me a guess. Do you think that this is new or old changes? We know now by the look of it, it's interstitial. But is it acute or chronic interstitial changes when you look at this? To me, I would say that this is chronic. Why is that? Because the marking usually will be distorted. You will not have the regular anatomical changes or the anatomical distribution of the interstitium. You can see the signs of distinct and distorted structure. And mostly this is related to the fibrosis and the traction that comes with the fibrosis. As we mentioned, the hazy, not distorted, usually acute. When it's sharp and you can see it very clearly and it's distorted, this is indicate a chronic fibrotic changes with some traction happening there. Let's review an X-ray and going and reviewing it by the systematic way. We said that we are going to look in the least interest, and least interest we are starting by the are there many lung lesions, starting with the A abdomen. And then let's say that we are missing, and we are saying that this is the diaphragm, which is not, but however, let's say we looked at this homogeneous area and we said it's clear, diaphragm is there, and it's clear that this is the liver, and then I go there and this is the stomach. And even though I missed that this is the real diaphragm, and this is air under the diaphragm, when I go and the next step and I went to the thorax, I also should appreciate, if I said that this diaphragm, I should appreciate that there is a white structure that are not either vessels or a bone. So that's why a systematic approach is really important, not to miss really important things like a pneumoperitoneum here. And then you can go into the thorax, mediastinum, and then lungs. But this is only to show you the importance of looking into the areas of least interest. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, now we'll talk about the lobar anatomy. So how many lobes do we have in the lungs? We have three on the right side and two on the left side. Since we have only two, it means we have only one fissure on the left side, which is the major fissure. How do we see the fissures on the X-ray? When the beam of the X-ray comes and it finds a perpendicular or an oblique line, it will not be reflected on the cassette that is behind it. It needs to be parallel to the beam to see the white stuff on the X-ray. What does that mean? This white stuff. You can only see the major fissure on the lateral view. You will never see the major fissure on the AP view because it is oblique to the beam of the X-ray. So now we are usually seeing the fissures are very thin line in the lungs, but there's two exceptions when we see them as more than that. The first exception is when we have a consolidated loop. So you can see that it's so clear in here. And then the other one is when there is pleural fluid going inside the fissures, filling these fissures from inside. So the lobes are not filled or consolidated, but the fluid is moving to inside the major and minor fissures. Major fissures start from the fifth thoracic vertebra and goes down toward the almost anterior chest wall and on the diaphragm. Here, which separates usually the upper and lower on both sides. Okay. However, on the right side, what do we have? This is the major fissure on the right side. We have a minor fissure going anterior to it. So what does that mean? So minor fissure, when it goes anterior, it splits what? The upper or lower loop? It splits the upper loop.
Upper and middle.
Yeah, it splits. It's we have the major fissure. Behind the major fissure, we have lower loop. In front of the major fissure, we have upper loop. Then there will be another fissure goes horizontally toward the anterior chest wall, splitting the upper loop into two halves. It's the upper and the middle below it. So upper is above it and the middle is below it. It's important why when we localize a disease, we are talking about, let's say on this, we have the major fissure coming here, and then we have the minor fissure. So what is the loop that is between them? It's the abnormality that we are seeing or the density we are seeing, it's in the right middle loop. This is how we can localize the disease. Because when you look in the AP view, you might say that this can be what? Can be either what or what? It can be right middle or right lower, because it's all in this area, the right lower and the right low. So when you look at the site, when you see this, it's anything that we said when there is a consolidated loop, we see the fissure. So we are seeing the right middle loop or the minor fissure. Anything below the minor fissure is a right middle loop. So we localize the disease based on the anatomical information that we have. So this is just to look at X-ray and immediately describe the lesion. When you say, If you don't want to say just the upper zone, lower zone, middle zone, you can say that this anything above the aortic knob is definitely an upper lobe. So if you see any infiltration in this area, you say that there is infiltration either in the right or left upper lobes. Three and five, as we just mentioned, this can be either middle or lower lobe. Okay, how do we know? We have to look at the lateral view. Three and four here. This is definitely what if you look. There's no differentials.
Lower lobe.
Yeah, because anything behind the major fissure is lower lobe. Five, we said anything below the minor fissure is middle lobe. Six, this is a little bit tricky. It's the lingula. It is part of the upper lobe on the left side. It's a segment, not a lobe. Seven, we are saying that the seven is the left diaphragm. Why did not we say that this is a right diaphragm?
View on the left side or?
No, before two, because we're looking at the, no, we're looking at the lateral. We're not looking at the anterior. Why did we say that this is left?
Because of the lung loops.
On the left side, you cannot tell, صح? In the left, in the lateral, you cannot tell unless you look at something. Which side is higher? Is it the right dome or the left dome of diaphragm?
The right one.
صح. So this is the right because it's higher, and this is the left. It's lower. One other thing. The left, the heart is sitting on the left diaphragm. So anything that goes below the heart, does not cross the heart, is the left. So there's two reasons why did we know that this is left. Okay, moving forward. These are the fissures. There is some accessory fissures that you don't need to know about. That the azygos accessory usually doesn't have in the all. But this is what? Minor fissure. Three, forget about it, also is the inferior accessory. And then we have the fourth, which is, as we just mentioned, the right, which is the higher and also crossing the heart. So this is right side. And then we have the minor fissure. And then the left major, which we know that goes below the heart because it's lower and it goes below the heart. We know it's the minor fissure. Okay. Can somebody tell me where is that pin, the foreign body that is already on the airway? Where is that pin? What's the location of that pin? We said that, by the way, this is the pin. We know that this area, we said it can be either what or what?
It can be the lower or the middle lobe.
Okay, and is this middle or lower?
It is the middle lower lobe.
In the?
Lower.
Lower, how did you know it's the lower?
Comparing to the lateral view, Doctor, it's obviously in the lower lobe.
Because it is behind the? It is behind the?
The major fissure. The major.
So anything behind the major fissure, yani, it will be in the lower lobe. So it can be here, so you'll not be very sure. Anything behind the main, we can definitely now say that this is the right lower lobe, okay, by looking at the lateral. Okay, any question? Okay, Selwood sign. What is Selwood sign? Selwood signs is talk about the radiographical densities. We have usually four densities in the lung and the x-rays. We have the gas, the fat, soft tissue, and the water densities. And they are different based on of the x-ray beam that goes in. So Selwood sign, what is Selwood sign? Selwood sign is when you have two structures of similar density. يعني غاز جنب غاز density جنب bone density, they will obscure each other. خلاص, you cannot tell them apart from each, يعني like this. Who can see the right dome of the diaphragm? Can you? No. So right dome, we can see the left dome of the diaphragm, but we cannot see the, this is the ribs. This is the ribs. This is a bone density. That's why we can see it. But there is soft tissue density, which we know that the diaphragm is a soft tissue density. And I am sure that there is an adjacent structure giving soft tissue density next to the dome. Okay. What is this soft tissue density? This means that one of the lobes has fluid in it. Okay. One of the lobes has fluid in it. Is it, طب احنا قلنا هذه الاريا can be what or what?
Middle and lower.
Okay. هل الاريا هذه middle ولا lower? تذكروا احنا تكلمنا عن انه الهارت is anterior structure عشان كذا احنا نقربه من الكاسيت حق الاكس راي بيم. فاذا الهارت anterior structure معناها انه الهارت is adjacent to something not have the same density. معناه إنه الهارت is a soft tissue density جوات بس جنبه في air. لأنه لو كان جنبه في fluid ما راح نشوف الهارت. بس الديافرام جنبه في fluid. We could not appreciate. بما إنه الانتيريور compartment من هذه air is already aerated. معناها مين اللي aerated؟ مين اللي فيه air الآن في المنطقة هذه؟ The right middle ولا the right lower؟
Right middle.
The right middle في air because it's touch. Touching the heart. So we know that the right, there is density on the or infiltration on the right. Yes.
ممكن بستعيد آخر نقطة لأن الصوت قطع.
Okay. So when we are saying that which area is aerated, احنا تكلمنا عن السيلوتينج. سيلوتينج معناها two densities similar to each other on the same place. هما نفس الدنسيتي وبنفس المكان. Okay. The heart is fluid density or soft tissue density. والديافرام is soft tissue density. هنا في المنطقة هذه احنا عندنا أبيض compared to the left. في هنا أبيض هنا أسود. هذا الأبيض إيش؟ Is it right middle or right lower؟ كيف أعرف؟ أروح أشوف السيلوتينج. Is it silhouetting the heart or silhouetting the diaphragm? If it's silhouetting the heart, then it's that there is fluid in the right middle lobe. If it's silhouetting the diaphragm, it is the right lower lobe. معناها أنه right lower lobe is involved and it has the infiltration in the right lower lobe. فمن الإكسراي على طول حتى لو ما سوينا lateral كثير إحنا نسوي X-ray AP ويجينا الراديولوجيكال ريبورت saying أنه في عندك right lower lobe involved. ما قال لي right middle لأنه شاف الهارت. بما انه شاف الهارت معناها انه هنا في air next to it. Clear?
No, the just the last point, the silhouetting, if we can repeat it, I didn't understand.
طيب, شوف هنا انت شايف البوردر حق الهارت؟
ايه.
Okay, اذا انت شايف ايش معنى silhouetting اصلا؟ Silhouetting يعني two densities, same location. Two similar densities in the same location.
Okay.
خلاص الهارت is a soft tissue density. Next to it mean right middle lobe لأنه anterior structure. الهارت is an anterior structure. So next to it بيصير right middle lobe. إذا right middle lobe فيه air معناها بشوف البوردر حق الهارت. إذا right middle lobe فيه fluid ما راح أشوفه لأنه بيصير silhouetted مع right مع الهارت.
أوكي.
عرفت؟ أما إذا الديافرام شفته معناها أنا مشور إنه left lower lobe right lower lobe فيه air. لأنه في different density between the air وبين soft tissue. ف when I'm not seeing the diaphragm, I'm sure that they're right lower. لما أشوف the heart معناها إنه right middle is aerated. Clear?
Okay.
طيب عشان كده مهم جدا نعرف كل شيء وين مكانه. Anterior or posterior. The right heart border is what? Anterior زي ما قلنا تو. Descending aorta هي تطلع من قدام تصير في النص بعدين ترجع ورا. Descending معناها posterior. Left heart border also is an anterior. Descending aorta, ascending sorry aorta is an anterior. And then aortic knob is in between. It's the middle position. So this will help us in defining where is the lesion S. So if we see here, we can follow the aortic knob, but then عندي descending aorta ونازل descending aorta. معناها مين اللي ما هو involved؟ مين اللي aerated؟ إذا أنا شايف descending aorta والdescending aorta فيه fluid. مين اللي aerated؟ مين اللي فيه هواء الآن؟ هل هو اللور ولا اللور احنا قلنا ايش؟ يكون posterior للمين؟ للميجر فيشر صح؟
yes.
معناها انه هنا في اير في البوستيريور اللي معناها الليفت لور لوب از ايريتد ما هو مشكله. المشكله في جزء من الابر لوب منه اللي هو ايكويفالنت للرايت ميدل لوب في الجهه الثانيه اسمه ايش السيجمنت هذاك اللي مغطي لي الليفت بوردر اوف ذا هارت. مين اللي لامس الليفت بوردر اوف ذا هارت؟ اللينجولا. فانا ماني شايف البوردرز كلير في اللنج هنا في الهارت فمعناها اللينجولا انفولد هذه فانا عندي لينجولار انفلتريت هنا الهارت والله فيري كلير اللينجولا ما فيها اير اكيد ما هي انفولد لكن اي لوست الدايف السندنج اورتا ويجيني هنا من دون ما يشوف اللاترال فيو قال لي والله في ترى عندك انفلتريشن ان دي left lower lobe لانه ايش هو lasted the descending aorta. في شيء ثاني مين يقدر يقول لي شيء ثاني هو شافه عشان يتاكد انه left lower lobe involved؟ في silhouetting ثاني صاير غير descending aorta. ايش اللي هنا شايفينه هذا ايش؟ diaphragm.
diaphragm.
طب احد شايف diaphragm هنا؟
no.
اوكي معناها الليفت لور لوب انفولف ديفينتلي عشان تو ثينجز عشان الديسندنج اورتا راح وعشان الليفت دايفرام راح. هنا هذه بس فور براكتس ات ويل شو اس هاو كان وي ديسكرايب. هذا انا من يوم اشوف فيشر عندي هنا اي شيء اباف ات معناها انه احنا قاعدين نتكلم عن هذا ممكن يكون ايش وايش ممكن يكون رايت ابر وممكن يكون رايت لور لانه هذه المنطقه فيها رايت ابر ورايت لور. احنا قلنا لما يكون above الليفل حق الأورتيك نوب هذا definitely هذا upper زي هذه لكن ما دام انها lower انا من يوم شفت البوردر حقة الماينر فيشر عرفت انه احنا قاعدين نتكلم عن upper low. هنا مين اللي silhouetted تتذكروا مين كان الستركتشر اللي هنا ينزل
الديسندنج
aorta أورتيك نوب الديسندنج aorta موجود أورتيك notch معناها هذا ميدل ستركتشر هذا في المحول المدياستم in the middle. طيب أحد شايف الديافرام هنا is lost so هذا left lower هنا ال right heart border is lost this is the right middle okay هنا right lower هذا lingula it is clear واضحة؟ في أحد مفاهم ها السلوتينج؟
بس كثر نقطة الديافرام it is lost كيف يعني
يعني انا ما اقدر اشوف شوفي هذا لاين هذا دايفرام بعدين اختفى بعدين رجع هنا بس المنطقه هذه في دايفرام لاست ما في صار سلوتد مع معناها الجزء من اللور لوب هذا في مويه داخله سيم دنسيتي سيم لوكيشن فما صار في بينهم ديماركيشن واضح معناها انه هنا هذا الديزيز اريا من اللنك هذا الرايت لور لوب هذا رايت ميدل لانه شال لي البوردر حق الهارت ما صرت اشوف البوردر حق الهارت هنا شال لي البوردر حقت الدايفرام فما فخلاص راح انا متاكد انه هنا عندي ليفت لور لوب انفلتريشن اوكي لو كان عندك بوزيتيف سيلويت هذه هيلبفل لو كانت نيجاتيف داز نوت اكسكلود ليش لانه احيانا اللوب يكون بارشلي ايريتد partially irritated يعني يكون في ديزيز بس ما هو كامل فممكن you will see the border of that involved area A positive silhouette is helpful. خلاص هذا السلوت. نتكلم عن الاير برونكوغرام. إيش يعني الاير برونكوغرام؟ معناها إنه الاير واي تتذكروا لما تكلمنا في الاناتومي إنه عندنا اير واي اللي ما هي related لاير سبيس. الاير واي إحنا عادة ما نشوفه لأنه الاير سبيس فيه اير. الحين هذه تقريبا صارت عكس السلوت صار المفروض انه يصير في سلوتينج بتوين الاير واي والاير سبيس، لكن لانه الاير سبيس صار جواته مويه مين اللي صار واضح وديماركيتد؟ الاير واي. فكانه تريكيا صار نازل من التريكيا بعدين صار في برانشينج وبرانشينج وبرانشينج. المفروض المناطق هذه يكون فيها اير فالمفروض تسوي سلوتينج مع الاير واي. فالاير سبيس لما صار في مويه صرت اشوفه، معناها انا استنتج لما اشوف برونكوغرام انه المناطق اللي في الاير سبيس هذا ديزيز از انفلتريتد وذ ووتر. زي هنا مين شايف البرونكوغرام اير برونكوغرام؟
Yes.
It is in the, you can see behind the heart, طبعا لأنه الهارت هو anterior. Behind the heart we can see branching structure. معناها أنا استنتجت أنه المكان اللي فيه الايرواي هذا المناطق اللي هنا ما هي similar، المفروض أنها تكون سلوتد معاها. بما أنها صرت أشوف الديماركيشن والاير برونكوغرام ديستالي ما هو زي التريكيا والهذا، معناها أنه في فلويد بالمنطقة هذه. فيجيني الراديولوجيست يقول لي عندك infiltration في الليفت لور، ليش ما قال لي انها والله قدام؟ لانه هذا بيهايند الهارت والهارت از انتيريور ستراكشر، فما في عنده. فانا عندي هنا انفلتريشن فدائما يحطها انفلتريشن في المنطقه هذه. خلاص هنا شفتها برضو كمان، وكمان في ساينز ثانيه. يس غير اني عندي اير برونكوغرام انا مور ديفينيتيف. ليش؟ مين اللي لاست عندي كمان هنا؟ نرجع اللي تكلمنا عنه سلويت، ما اشوف البوردر حق الديافرام. اوكي راح مني البوردر حق الديافرام، فمعناها انا متاكد انه في انفلتريشن في الليفت لور لوب، ما عندي ديافرام وعندي اير برونكوغرام. كلير؟
يس كلير.
طيب الحين لما يصير عندي اير برونكوغرام افري وير، هذه تشوفونها في الاي سي يو، ايش معناها؟ صار الاير برونكوغرام كل مكان في برونكوغرام، معناها انه في جنرالايزد سيستميك ديزيز يسمونه في الاي سي يو انه capillary leak syndrome. ايوه يصير ARDS. ARDS معناها انه صار في leak inside the airways inside the airspace، والair space هذا لما صار ابيض سوى سوى برونكوغرام مع الايرويز، صار not silhouetted. خلاص صار not silhouetted مع الاير، فسوى لي diffuse air برونكوغرام. فهذا لما تشوفونها الاي سي يقول اوكي دخلنا في الARDS. اوكي الآن كمان من الميزات اللي عندنا في الاير برونكوغرام، لو أنا عندي وايد ميدياستنم زي كذا ولقيت جواته اير برونكوغرام، أنا مشور إنه I'm not in the ميدياستنم، I'm still in the lungs، وأقدر أقول إنه هذه بارت من الأبر لوب ما هي ميدياستنم، لأنه whenever there is air برونكوغرام it's not a ميدياستنم، it's related to the airways، هذا لسه branching inside. لكن لما تروح مني البرونكوغرام maybe or maybe not، maybe it's inside the lung maybe it's not، خلاص ممكن تكون بالمنري ممكن تكون extra بالمنري، زي هذه الحالة ممكن تكون infiltration، هذا ممكن تكون infiltrated. طيب هذا will lead us to what to other subject اللي هو collapse. كيف نعرف إذا كان في collapse وخلى اللنج كاملة تسكر زي هذه؟ ممكن لما دائما الراديولوجيست يكتب لك infiltration slash collapse وصارت كلها أبيض versus إنها تكون infiltration. طبعاً لنجد نتكلم عن collapse versus atelectasis، طبعاً they are the similar thing بس usually collapse is more يعني involving larger area. هنا collapse وين موجود؟ موجود في the whole left lung. ليش؟ أول شيء عندي شفت في الميدياستنم عندي التريكيا راحت كلها يمين، الهارت ما في له أي أثر في الرايت سايد راح لليسار، فعندي definitely إيش left lung collapse. طيب في شيء ثاني ممكن من الساينز اللي هذا، لو كان فيه هنا الديافرام يمديك تشوفه، طبعا أنت ما تشوفه ليش؟ لأنه في سلوتينج بين الديافرام واللنج تيشو فخلاص، لكن definitely it is elevated. ليش؟ will be pulled by the collapsed lung. طيب هنا ايش ال collapsed area؟
في الرايت اب
رايت ابر لو.
ليش؟ لما ايوه انت تعرف انه الماينر فيشر طالع من الميجر فيشر ورايح هوريزونتالي قدام، المفروض يكون لاين زي كذا، لما اشوفه طالع فوق معناها انسحب هذا. ف it's the most important sign then للإليفيت عشان تقول لي إنه والله هنا ما هو infiltration في الرايت أبر، أنا I'm sure إنه كولابس. عشان كذا أروح النادي الأرتي وخليه يسوي chest physiotherapy to remove the block، لأنه أنا أقول له كولابس ما هي infiltration. بيقول لك لا دكتور it's pneumonia give him antibiotics no this needs chest physio خلاص. And mostly this lobe is usually involved في bronchiolitis. هنا الساينز هذا الرايت ميدل، هذا الماينر فيشر طلع فوق، هذا معناها انه رايت ابر لوب از كولابس. عندي الماينر فيشر نزل معناها في الرايت ميدل لوب. عندي هذا ايش، هذا ميجر فيشر، هذا لانه جاي من ورا شاطف من ورا ويبدا يطلع هنا، لو شفته نزل او لقيت انه في اللاترال فيو رجع على ورا معناها احنا نتكلم عن الرايت لوبر لوب كولابس. في الليفت سايد عندي يا يطلع قدام يا يرجع وراء اللي هو الميجر فيشر، فمعناها يا رايت أبر يا رايت لور. في هذه الحالة هنا في هذا البيشن البوردر هذه بتتذكر روح شفنا تو كذا طلع على فوق كان صارت نازل على تحت. ثاني شغلة إنه الميجر فيشر كمان بشت انتيريورلي، فمعناها إنه مين عندي كولابس، مين اللي صاير مرة صغير الرايت ميدل لوب، بدل ما هو صار كذا كذا صار بوشت وصار كولابس، فبولينج الميجر والماينر فيشر. هنا
دكتور اذا امكن لو ترجع الصوره اللي قبلها بس، وين الميجر فيشر؟
الميجر فيشر هنا، شوف هذا هذا الميجر فيشر بعدين رايح قدام في ده مسوي بوينج على قدام. أوكي. بعدين هنا الماينر فيشر بدل ما يروح كذا، انت تشوف الماوس ولا لا؟
ايوه ايوه شوف هي
بدل ما يصير كذا ينازل على تحت، فصار كانه مضغوط، هو بالعكس ساحب الفيشرز توارد ات هنا. طيب هنا ايش صاير؟
طيب هنا يو دونت سي الدايافرام وبرضه الرايت كاردييك شادو.
طيب معناها انه الانفولفمنت وين؟
لور ميدل لوب
ولا بس الميدل لوب؟ طب الميدل لوب لو كان انفولد ما راح تشوف الهارت،
نشوف الدايفرام.
طب هل انت تشوف الدايفرام؟
لا
برضو كمان يعني رايت وميدل كلهم. طيب سو عشان يعني نلخصها، الماين الموفمنت اوف ذا فيشر از ذا موست ريلايبل ساين اوف لوبر كولابس، مو دائما نلقاها بس انها وان اوف ذا ساينز اللي هي الدايركت ساين اوف كولابس. لو شفت الميجر فيشر ولا الماينر فيشر متحرك من مكانه معناها هذا كولابس. في اشياء ثانيه زي ايش؟ زي الكراودنينج اوف ذا فيسلز والبرونكاي في البرونكيما، هذه زي لما نشوف اير برونكوغرام بعيد هنا، لكن لو شفتهم اير برونكوغرام متباعدين عن بعض غير عن اير برونكوغرام كراودنينج. كراودنينج عشان كذا دائما صعبه وتلقى الراديولوجيست يكتب لك سلاش كولابس انفيلتريتس، لانه مو احيانا ما هو متاكد مره، بس one of the indirect signs is crowding of the air bronchograms اللي تحت. طيب shift of the adjacent structure كمان لو كان عندك الهايلر ديبريشن معناها اللور لوب هو اللي كولابس، لو الهايلر اليفيشن معناها الابر لوب سحبها. الميدل واللينجولا does not move the hilum خلاص لانهم بالنص. الهايلر shift usually indirect sign ما هي major sign ف it will not give you full picture. 97 من الهايلم دائما الليفت سايد از اليفيتد، فلما تشوف الرايت سايد اليفيتد وتشك انه عندك رايت ابر لوب كولابس ذس مايت تيل يو ذات انه في عندنا كولابس، هذه اندايركت ساين كمان. طيب الدنسيتيز هذه من الساينز اوف كولابس اجين اذر ذان الموفمنت، لما يصير عندنا تتذكروا لما قلنا الكومبيرنج انا ديفينتلي هنا عندي لوسنسي اكثر من هنا وهنا مور دنسيتي هنا لوسنت، فلما اجي اشوف اللوسنسي هذا تراينج تو فيل الاريا هذه او الفويد اللي صار عندي. وين الاريا هذه موجوده؟ اول شيء انا شايف الستومك بابل هنا، شايفينه الستومك بابل طالع فوق،
يس اليفيتد
طالع فوق ابوف الدايف رايت سايد، معناها انه في قاعد شيء يسحبه فوق. مين اللي يسحب الدايفرام فوق؟ نطلع نشوف اي معناها انه في عندي كولابس. الكولابس هذا وين؟
ليفت لور،
اللفت لور لو هو كولابس. فيه ساينز الدايفرام والله ما صرت اي كنات ابريشيت الايدج حقته، ما في عندي ديسندنج اورتا هنا خلاص. وهذا ايش فيه؟ راديو لوسنت. ليش؟ لانه اللنج تيشو صار توزع على مساحة أوسع عشان يعبي مكان اللور لوب، فصار مور بلاك، بينما هذا متجمع في مكان أكثر فصار يسوي أبزوربشن للإكس راي بيم. طيب كيف يصير الكولابس؟ لو صار في أوبستركشن في البرونكس، الأير اللي موجود ديستل له مع التايم will be resorbed، يمتصه الجسم. لو صار في كومبريشن من الأدجيسنت ستركتشر كمان، لو كان في سكارينج في اللنج وصار في كونتراكشن وكلوزد اريا زي ما يصير احيانا في الفايبروتيك والانترستيشال لنج ديزيزز، او صار السيرفاكتنت في مشكله فخلى الالفيولاي والكولابس زي ما راح نتكلم عنها بعدين في اليونيت، او انه واحد نيوروماسكولر does not take deep breath with time, his lung will have multiple atelectatic changes and have recurrent chest infection related للأتلاكتاسيس، لأنه فيها stasis وفيها fluid staying in that area وبعدين تتقفل، بعد ما تتقفل تصير area for infection. هذا الميكانيزمز usually what happens. Children usually ما يصير عندنا إلا related to mucus plug زي ما يصير في bronchiolitis، أو لما يصير عندك foreign body in the airway. طبعا كيف نعرف انها سنترال فيرسس؟ اذا احنا شفنا كل الساينز اوف ذا كولابس بعدين لقينا انه ما عندي اير برونكوغرام، معناها ان المشكله ايش؟ سنترال ما هي ديستال. لكن والله لو في كولابس والمشكله وعندي اير برونكوغرام معناها فيه وفي كراودنج في الاير برونكوغرام، معناها انه المشكله ديستال. وانا لما يجي احد يقول لي تعال سوي لي سكوب ريموفل الميوكس بلاك، بقول له انا اي كانوت تريس ات downward. هي ما هي مشكلة proximal أو central أقدر أروح أشيلها، هي مشكلة diffused all over the lung. أنا متأكد إنه ما في شيء proximal أقدر أروح أسحبه وخلاص وتنفتح اللنج. clear؟ طيب هنا which loops are collapsed؟ هذا مين؟ هذا which line؟ left. إيش؟ diaphragm. معناها ما صار للسلوتينج. مين اللي على الديفرام؟ دائما نقول اللور.
Yes.
اللور يعني في اير ولا لا؟
Yes, because we can see.
خلاص ما دام انه في اير معناه في واحد. طب ليش هو اعلى من الليفت من الرايت سايد؟ معناه في شيء ساحبه فوق. مين؟
الليفت
ابر. الليفت ابر. طيب كيف ادري انه ابر؟ مسوي سلوتينج مع مين؟ مين اللي انا ماني شايفه هنا اصلا ولا انا شايف ديماركيشن له ولا شيء؟ مين المفروض يكون هنا وانا ماني شايفه اصلا؟
الهارت.
الهارت كله ماني شايفه. ليش؟ لانه حوالينا سلوتد مع الليفت ابر لوب، فخلاص انا يعني ماني شايفه، بالاضافه انه الديفرام اليفيتد معناها انه موضوع كولابس مو موضوع انفلتريشن. لانه في يجي احد يقول لك طب هذا انفلتريشن، والله مو انفلتريشن. ليش؟ لانه عندي الديفرام طلع معاه فوق. ثاني شيء ما في اي ساين للهارت في الرايت سايد. لو كان انفلتريشن كان ويل بوش ذا هارت تو ذا اذر سايد. الهارت ما هو باين هنا صح؟ فهذا طلع فوق، معناها انا عندي مين؟ الليفت ابر لوب كولابس. في شيء ثاني يقول لك انه ما هو لور
descending
aorta. ما دام انك شايفه كلير زي كذا معناها ان اللور is well demarcated، معناها descending aorta جنبه air. اوكي طيب this will lead us to the last part من الـ lecture اللي هو neonatal chest imaging. عشان neonatals mainly x-rays فبنطبق اللي تكلمنا عليه في neonates. عندنا في neonates we divide them يا إن preterm يا إما term infants ولا إنه air leak related للventilation. في preterm infants إحنا عندنا RDS وBPD. تكلم عن ال RDS مشكلتها إيش؟ surfactant is deficient. لما يصير surfactant deficiency تكلمنا احنا في الكولابس ميكانيزمز ايش يصير؟ الالفيولاي will be deflated عشان will not have a surface tension فبيصير will be collapsible، سهل انها will be collapsed. لما تصير كولابس بيصير في عندنا ايش؟ هذا it's alveoli، معناها انه gas exchange area فبيصير hypoxia، فبيصير عندنا كمان high force عشان نفتح الالفيولاي هذه، لانه احنا عندنا surface tension راح فبيصير عندي barotrauma وcomplication لها. الكولابس والاتلاكتاسيس والكوز هايبوكسيا والكوز انفلاماتوري رياكشن والديكريز اللور لنج فوليوم اند انكريز البلمونري اديما. اللي تكلمنا عنه الانكريز هاير انرجي تو اوبن اب اللنج والكوز باروتروما. خلاص ذس از ويل كوز ذا الاندوميثيليال دامج اند بعدين يصير عندنا غاز اكستشينج ديفكت وذ هاير لاين ميمبرين ذات يهمنا كيف نعرفها في الإكس راي. granularity bilaterally, هذه granularity related ل what ل partially collapsed segments inside. عندك air bronchogram لأنه ال فيه crowding صاير. إحنا قلنا air bronchograms لما يصير near each other يصير معناها related ل ل ل ل collapse. وأهم شيء اللي هي low lung volume معها. White out of the lung usually happen later on because of the inflammatory process اللي يصير بعد ال complete collapse. They might have white out of the lung. طيب, because it is not a genuine interstitial problem, it's related to the airway. لما تعطيهم surfactant, إيش يصير? They open up بعد surfactant. إيش الcomplication اللي ممكن تصير? يا أما air leak. عشان احنا قلنا باروتروما ولا انفكشن ولا بي بي دي ليتر اون ولا بالمونري هايبرتنشن ريليتد للغاز اكسشينج بروبلم اللي تحصل بسبب الهايبوكسيا. في البي بي دي احنا عندنا مشكله البري ديسبوزيشن اللي هو البريماتوريتي والميكانيكال فنتريشن والاكسجين ثيرابي. طبعا اوفر تايم اول ذس ويل ليد تو الباثولوجي اللي هي ريليتد لي. هنا الحين احنا نتكلم عن مور توارد ان انترستيشال انفلتريشن بروبلم. خلاص فصار عندنا فيبروسيس وعندنا الفيولر سيستر هيبليجيا وميتابليزيا وبعدين الراديولوجيكال باترن اللي ينجم عن هذا اللي هو ايش البرانكيمال ديزيز. برانكيما احنا قلناها مظله كبيره تشمل انترستيشال واير سبيس. هايبر انفليشن. ليش هايبر انفليشن؟ تتذكروا الاوبستراكتيف ديزيزز من ضمنها هذه. There will be air going in sometimes and going out. Architectural distortion لما تكلمنا عن الساينز اوف كرونيك interstitial pattern يصير الاركيتكتشر حقها it will be distorted. خلاص عندنا differentiation between the radiological pattern قبل وبعد ما صار السيرفاكتنت يستخدم. قبل السيرفاكتنت يستخدم we always have to have these complete opacity and granulation initially. وعندنا برونكوغرام. ليش اول كان ما في سيرفاكتنت وخلاص اللنج will collapse ويبقى عندنا الايرواي مفتوح فراح يسوي will not have silhouette مع الها مع اللنج وبيبان عندي ديفيوز برونكوغرام كانها بيكتشر اوف اي ار دي اس انستد بدال الاي ار دي اس يكون فيها فلويد هذه لا كولابس. بعدين عندي الستيج الثانيه اللي هي الكومبليت اوباسيفيكيشن زي ما قلنا عنها هذه كونتينوس للسيم اريا لكنها ستيل هاف ا سمولر لنج فوليوم. Later on, we will have the chronic changes اللي دائماً تحصل بعد واحد بعد شهر تقريباً اللي هو related to distortion of the architecture of the lung وصار عندي cysts, lucencies, circles. هذه كلها خلاص signs of chronic interstitial infiltrated related to the fibrosis اللي صار. هذا قديم. خلاص. الآن عندنا new PPD. It's a simplification. ال growth is suppressed at the side. فبيصير عندي شوية haziness. ليش؟ لأنها partially opened lung. خلاص compared لل previously لما قلنا إنه عندنا complete opacification وما صار عندنا distortion اللي يصير مثل الأول. reticulation تصير بس أقل. الفيبروسيس يصير أقل. هنا طبعاً picture من CT scan تبين لك كيف ال previously كيف الفيبروسيس كان very bad. خلاص will lead to accumulation of air inside. في الـ term infants إيش عندنا mainly TTN. TTN is related to what باقي شوية fluid ما طلعت من اللنج. فإيش معناها إيش بيصير tachypneic خلاص لأنه affecting the gas exchange شوي. He wants to open up. فنروح نسوي الـ X-ray just to exclude other causes. نروح نسوي الـ excluding the other causes. إيش راح نلقى في عندنا increase symmetrically interstitial opacity is إيش related للفلويد اللي جوا. لكن مهم جدا انه عندي well inflated lung عشان ما نقول انها RDS وكمان خلاص لان هذه differentiating it from RDS. بعدين diffuse fine granular opacity maybe maybe not بس it's not usual. خلاص ايش اللي يدل انه عندي تتذكروا لما تكلمنا عن ال veins اللي موجوده بال interlobular spaces يصير عندك streaks of هذه الستريكس. شايفين الستريكس هذه الستريكس ريليتد لانه الفينز قاعده تشيل الفلويدز اللي موجوده في اللنج اللي هي خلاص كليرنج اب اللنج. فا يو كان مايت سي ذا ستريكس اوف بلاد اند لاينز اوف فلويد ان ذا فيشرز. هنا هذا الماينر فيشر في جواته في فلويد في some effusion وما عندي مشكلة في الفوليوم. نجي المشكلة الثانية في الترم infants اللي هي الميكونيوم aspiration. في الميكونيوم aspiration احنا عندنا الميكونيوم will go inside and either will occlude the airway, طبعا ايش بيسوي لك collapse او atelectasis زي ما تكلمنا من اول, او انه partially will close it فيسوي لك complication انه forming and then these chemicals will irritate the lung and will cause you picture of pneumonitis or pneumonia, any alveolar pattern. الميكونيوم aspiration ممكن يجيك multiple pictures واللونج تيرم بالمنري vasoconstriction because of the gas exchange involvement. Yes.
بس ممكن تعيد لأن الصوت قطع في السلايد هذا.
الـ airway احنا قلنا انه either it will be occluded فيصير معك atelectasis او partially because of the hyperinflation لما قلنا الـ air in not out, بعدين with time this will cause air leak and we will talk about that, او برونكيمال irritation يعني يصير عندك infiltration زي النيمونيا زي signs of pneumonia اللي شفناها في الاكسريز الاولى. شيء ثاني يسويه الميكونيوم انه ديأكتيفيت السرفاكتنج, بس لان الميكونيوم ما هو systematic ما هو symmetrically يعني ما هو diffuse على كل اللنج فبيصير areas فيها deactivated surfactant فبت will be having collapse فبيصير عندك باتشي ديزيز. خلاص تجي تناظر هذا المايل ديزيز تلقى فيه باتشي, تلاحظوا الباتشينس اللي موجودة في الميكونيوم, وعندنا started to have لأنه فيه some atelectasis فيه some reticulation واضح أنه كأن الانترستيشن بدأ يصير involved قريب من بعضها. أما في السيفير ديزيز لأنه deactivating الهول هذا it will appear as a picture of severe RDS, اللهم ان فيها areas that have more lucency زي كذا هذه more lucencies لانه الاريه هذه يدخل فيها الاير بس ما يطلع ويسبب لي lucencies which might cause definitely air leak at the end. Pneumonias in general in neonates it's not specific يعني it can be looking as any other disease بس definitely it will have better inflation than the RDS. You might have some effusion there. Granular opacities also can be there. It is difficult really to differentiate. However, inflation is better. You might have some effusion, زي ما تشايفين هنا في effusion. هذا usually don't see it in RDS. طيب هذا multifocal course opacity. هذه تذكرك في بكتشر حقت الميكونيوم. Where is this multiple opacity? في less reticulation وما عندنا ال coalescing air cyst that usually we can see it in the severe meconium aspiration syndrome. طيب ال coalescing air space diseases هذه related لل air leak. ال air leak ممكن يحصل من أي مكان, ممكن يكون من اللنج نفسها البلورا من على برا, أو ممكن يكون من inside the alveoli, أو ممكن يكون من المديستينوم نفسه. It depends where it happens. It will cause either pneumothorax, ولا pneumomediastinum, ولا in the interstitium. لو صار التسريب في الانترستيشن معناها ال air will go back into ويخلي لك good demarcation. يمشي في الوز في الشيتس حقة ال airway. فيسوي لك pulmonary interstitial emphysema. ولا في ال بيسوي لك subcutaneous emphysema. In this case, we have what? Pneumothorax. It's clearly the lung. الحين هذا طبعاً patient is ventilated, the lung is still inflated. لكن however, we can see clear pneumothorax on the right side. Yes. And in this case, we have a supple lucencies. وين ها هذه lucencies? Clear. هذه ما هو زي ال يعني ال lucencies اللي نشوفها is related لأن well demarcated heart ولا diaphragm زايدة ال demarcation. فنروح نسوي lateral, مو lateral بالأصح اللي هو cross table. ليش؟ لأن إحنا قلنا إنه the air will rise. فمعناها راح نلقى the air clearly in front of the lung. Okay. Pneumomediastinum, how to, لو دخل عندي air inside the pneumomediastinum in a new unit, it will cause demarcation. طبعا ايش بيسوي لديماركيشن؟ يعني will, there will be no silhouetting between the heart ومين هذا؟ دائما في سيلوتينج in this area. لكن لو راح دخل الاير بتوين them راح السيلوتينج وصار عندي الانجل وين. مين هذا؟ ايش معناها؟ هنا thymic shadow هذا الهارت صار عندي الانجل وين خلاص. هي ستاك ساين هذا الشكل او انه سوالي الانجل وين ساين. فانا عرفت انه في عندي نمو مدياستنم بس مجرد اني شفت الاكس راي هذه مع انه ما في كلير ساين انه والله انا شايف اريا ما فيها تشو لانك تشو. في ساين ثانيه اي في ساين ثانيه وين هي هذه شايفين الديافرام هذا اسمه كونتينوس ديافرام ساين. الديافرام كانه واحد كونتينوس ديافرام ماشي من الاول للاخير معناها انه في اير كمان راح بلو الهارت. اوكي هذه ايش تذكر لما قلنا انه الاير والليك وبعدين يمشي ويسوي لي في الستريكس اللي جوا في الانترستيشيوم فيسوي لي الديماركيشن هذا اللي توورد جون كلهم رايحين وين توورد مين توورد الهايلم. هذا لما تسرب في الانترستيشيال سبيس متى تجي تحصل هذه يوجوالي فنتليتد بيشنت خلاص يا مرات تكون هول لنج مرات تكون سبيسيفيك اريا ولا سيجمنت يونيلاترال او بايلاترال خلاص. بعد ممكن مع الوقت الاريا الانترستيشيال هذا اللي تتجمع وتسوي لك سيست كمان زي كذا هذه سيست تتجمعت الاير في وان بليس ويصير عندنا نوماتوسيل. طيب في نمو بريكارديوم يس كيف نفرقها عن النمو مدياستنم؟ الكلير ديماركيشن يوجولي ذات سراوندز الهارت اند داز نوت جو فردر اب فما عندي ما صار عندي الانجل وينجز اللي هي كانت شايله الثايمك شادو لان الثايمك شادو الحين مسوي سلوت مع المدياستنال ستراكشر لكن الهارت نفسه في حوالينه اير فخلاص سوالي ويل ديماركيتد ولان الاير از انسايد فصار عندي النوم البريكارديوم واضح thin line كأنه الفشر اللي احنا كشفناه أول. أوكي that's it الله يعطيكم العافية.
يعطيك العافية دكتور.
الله يعافيكم. any question.
شكرا لك دكتور.
يعطيك العافية دكتور.
شكرا
لك. يعطيك العافية دكتور والله was very informative.
الله يعافيكم. الله يعافيك. No questions? خلاص بالتوفيق إن شاء الله.